down here is Ripple Rock, or was Ripple Rock.
That's right.
Just down, yeah, down the street
it's
here.
It's just north of Campbell River and Seymour Narrows. When I was 7 years old in my little, you know, schoolboy's outfit, of course, they all sat us down to watch the black and white TV, and it was, at that time, it was the largest non-nuclear explosion in history. And it was really sad. They weren't even sure. They thought it might create an earthquake. They thought it might create a tidal wave. They really had no idea. They thought it might set off the, you know, the fault. They were really concerned.
But they did it anyway.
Oh, of course. You know, industry, you know, had to get on. quite fascinating. The explosion took up the whole sky.
It was called Ripple Rock, and in reality, it was really two peaks of rock that jutted up from the seabed and extended to just a few feet below the water surface. The strong tidal currents, coupled with the effects of the rock peaks, were a hazard to navigation. By 1953, Ripple Rock had claimed 119 ships and 114 lives. In 1953, the Canadian government decided that something had to be done and sent in the National Research Council to look into the feasibility of tunneling under Seymour Narrows to blow up the rocks. When everything was done, 1,375 tons of dynamite were packed into the peaks. On April the 5th, 1958, the CBC turned on their cameras to capture the actual explosion in what would be the first coast-to-coast live television coverage.
10, 9, 8, 7.
At 9:31 in the morning of April the 5th, 1958, the button was pressed.
Fire.
Pieces flew 1,000 feet into the air. 370,000 tons of rock were shattered, and 320,000 tons of water were displaced. The result was the rock was no longer 9 feet beneath the surface at low tide. The channel was now 47 feet deep at low tide over the south pinnacle, 69 feet deep over the north pinnacle. Today, nearly 1 million cruise ship passengers annually pass over the now tranquil waters of Seymour Narrows. Campbell River is the crown jewel of Vancouver Island. It's an affordable, uncrowded seaside playground with great vistas, seaside walks, sheltered harbor, world-class fishing, and some of the greatest float-flying destinations in all of Canada. I'm John Lovelace, and hope you can join us again next week on Wings Over Canada.